What's up, peoples? It is your boy MM2K back again with another video for the Stadia dosage. But before we get too deep into it, do me a huge favor. Hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Rock those bells for notifications, please, so you know when your boy's dropping these doses. I appreciate all of y'all straight up because you know the deal. I am not too proud to ask. Let's get into it. Okay, let me do this because I want to make sure everybody can see this. Active. All right, so we got some good news here. I'm gonna get into what I just made enlarged in a little bit, but we got some good news here, and it's great to have good news in regards to Stadia, because not too long ago I dropped a video myself in regards to some disappointing things that happened with Stadia at the Game Awards. I'm not taking advantage of the advertisement possibilities there. Then also the community within itself had some concerns in regards to some of the promised releases that were coming in December. No word from Stadia, but then I think we got some reassurance that those games are still coming, so the community is pleased. And let me just say first and foremost as well, that don't believe that hoopla and that garbage about the Stadia community is dead, Stadia is dead. Here's what's going on, people. As someone that plays on Stadia every day on my phone, on a web browser, and even on the Chromecast, I can let you know there is nothing dead about this community. The community is growing. Is it massive yet? No. But the game system is still in early access, all right? Its full-fledged of features aren't coming until 2020, all right? And while it's in early access, the most enthusiastic people towards this technology are testing it out. They're enjoying it. Once it increases its software lineup, you know what I'm saying? Once the full gamut of features come out, then it'll be ready for mass consumption, and then we can talk about whether it's quote-unquote dead right now. This is early access. They're getting early adopters on. They're collecting data so they can make enhancements to try to improve the service for mass consumption, and particularly what I believe before the next set of generations consoles come out, because that 10.7 teraflops that even Digital Foundry confirmed that, yes, that's what they have, the output power, that them having that output power alone as their max is not going to do it. They're going to have to raise it. So they're going to be able to do that through us testing it out in this early access mode and making whatever upgrades they need to make. But again, the community is not dead, all right? They've just gone away from the hyperbolic places like Twitter, and they're dedicated to places like Reddit, where true Stadia enthusiasts will be. They filter out all the muck and all the garbage, and they're all on Reddit. So here's some good news via Reddit, speaking of that platform, and this is coming from Grace from Google, and it's titled Bonus Buddy Pass for Founders. And the post reads, "Hi everybody. In the spirit of the holidays, we have an early surprise gift for Stadia founders, an extra buddy pass. Give it to a friend, a family member, anybody you know who loves games. For more information on how to redeem your buddy pass, take a look at the infographic below." You know what I'm saying? So they just basically telling you, and I'll scroll down to the bottom. So just letting you know that you got to go into the app, the phone app, go to your message icon, get your, you know, reply that you want your buddy pass, and they'll send one to you. And then so it says, and it follows up here, to send your buddy pass and get your chosen friend or enemy gaming on Stadia, open the Stadia app and tap the envelope icon in the top left. Follow the prompts and give the gift to Stadia today. Please note, as soon as you tap send your buddy pass, you will receive a copy of your buddy pass code in your email just in case you need it again later. Okay, so here's a couple reasons why I think this is a great thing for them to do. First and foremost, a lot of people that got buddy passes, particularly myself, you know what I'm saying? We didn't take some common sense things into consideration. Now, what are those common sense things? Well, as it comes to those that are apprehensive about Stadia, that weren't the enthusiasts like myself, they fit into three categories. There are people that are just simply based in the outrage culture, and they just want to look, they want to follow the idiot herd and trample on something, right? Makes them feel better to belong, okay? Then there's the opposite side of that spectrum, where there's people that may have just been used to dedicated devices, weren't familiar with the technology, but they were interested. They just want to see how things go, you know what I'm saying? And then there were people in the middle, okay? There were people in the middle that kind of, you know, they talked like the people that I just mentioned, where they seemed like that they said, hey, if this is for me, I'll give it a try. But Google Stadia in its early access mode wasn't for them. Like, they weren't willing to pay for extra games, you know what I'm saying? And Destiny, which is the free game, the free games are Destiny, Samurai Showdown, Shadow of the Tomb Raider, and Farm Simulator, right? It's not the greatest free games right there that's going to win people's hearts and minds over. So they might have been interested in Red Dead, might have been interested in, you know, a Rage or Borderlands that's coming, and they're not willing to pay for it because I already have it on another console. So people like that that fit in the middle, in that third category, they've received buddy passes and they're not doing nothing with them, right? Like, this was a wrong time to give those people a buddy pass. So I want to say that preemptively before I finish this video. Make sure that when you get your buddy pass this time, you give it to somebody that you know is highly invested or interested in cloud gaming. You know what I'm saying? Show them the performance. Let them see how it works. Give them that buddy pass because you know they'll utilize it. Don't let it go to waste. You know what I'm saying? And I think Google's aware of that. Also, I think Google's aware of is that they're about to release their free model soon going into 2020, the 720p model. They're going to let people play with this 1080p high performance model, right? And then these people are going to be like, ooh, this is the stuff. Then they're going to go into the free model where the buddy pass run out. And they're going to be like, nah, you know what? I prefer that other model where it's $10 a month. And think about it. People say, oh, you got to pay $10 on top of buying your games. You guys are doing the exact same thing with PlayStation Now. I mean, PlayStation, PSN Plus, excuse me, and Xbox Live. You pay $10 a month to get online and you buy your games, right? So it's the same difference. So with that being said, for those that have experienced that in advance through a buddy pass and may try the 720 mode, be like, nah, I need that 1080. This is a smart move to keep those people reeled in. So I think it's a good thing altogether. You know what I'm saying? So again, for those that are founders like me, you're getting those buddy passes. I'm going to let you know, just in case this may have slipped past your radar, give it to somebody that's deserving, that's really going to play Stadia, that might be interested in cloud gaming or interested in the games that are available, particularly someone that you know that is interested in Stadia, not just Stadia, but Destiny. If you know that person is a Destiny freak, and the fact that Destiny is cross progression across all platforms, this will be a perfect gift for them. And with that said, that's it from your boy MM2K. Hey, yo, let me know what you think about what I had to say in the comment section below. Because like I always say, you're curious what I think. And if you like what I had to say and you want to check me out beyond the Stadia Doses platform, check out the links below to follow me. Check me out with the Broadband Bullies. Check out the brand new website. Check me out with the PNTS Network. And check me out with the Hard Knock Digital Culture. And oh yeah, PNTS Network has their own Discord. Make sure you follow that for the opportunity to win a PlayStation 4 Pro. Link is going to be below. With that said, you guys have a wonderful, wonderful gaming day. Peace.